How do you do? Oh, allow me to introduce myself.
I am the last sane sports fan.
I am a genius by trade.
One and welcome to the View from the Midwest. I just knew too much.
Welcome back to the View from the Midwest. It's been quite a while since I've been able to make a video. Kind of took a little bit of a hiatus there, but going to try to get back into it a little bit now and change up the format a little bit. Going to be a little more quick hitting, try to do more shorter videos as opposed to the long half hour shows, maybe even longer sometimes when I tended to ramble. We're going to see how this works out and just try to hit one little topic each time.
Let the games begin.
Obviously, the big one that's going on right now is the Deflategate going on with the New England Patriots. And I'm just going to preface all of this. This is more the fan side of me, the videos that I like to make from the fan's point of view. Obviously, I try to stay as professional as I can. But anyway, back to the main point that I want to talk about right now is the New England Patriots and the crap that's going on right now with the... if you want to call it with the stuff that's going on right now with the deflated balls. And let me preface this right now. I hate the New England Patriots. I hate them. I hate their coach. I hate their quarterback. I hate the fact that they win all the time because I've never liked any kind of dynasty with the exception of the Chicago Bulls because they were my team. And that's the way most people are. Most people don't like dynasties unless it's their team. And that's just kind of the way it is. We don't want to see the same teams win year in, year out, which is the reason why a lot of people don't like the Yankees, also given the fact that they spend a lot of money. That's neither here nor there. The thing that I don't understand about what's going on right now is with everything that's gone on with the Deflategate, they didn't gain a clear advantage by deflating the footballs. If you look at the statistics, they were actually better passing in the second half of the game than they were in the first half. And it was the first half of the game in which the balls were found to be deflated. So they didn't gain a clear advantage. Nothing really came of this. New England was going to beat Indianapolis whether they had deflated balls or whether they had overinflated balls. It was just the way that the game went down. There was very little in that contest where you could say, oh, if it didn't happen this way, or if this didn't happen, or if these balls were set up this way, that New England wasn't going to win. And that's taken nothing away from the Indianapolis Colts. They had an excellent season. Andrew Luck is going to be an excellent quarterback. I figure he's going to win at least one Super Bowl in his career, if not more. But the fact is, regardless of whether you love them or whether you hate them, the New England Patriots are one of the best run, best played, best coached teams in NFL history. It sickens me from deep down within my gut to say that. But the bottom line is when you look at the facts, Tom Brady is one of the best quarterbacks of all time. Bill Belichick, at least in his New England career, is one of the best coaches of all time. And the New England Patriots, from the time they won their first Super Bowl until now, are one of the best run organizations of all time. So it begs the question, why? Why does any of this occur? Because if you want to say that they are not cheaters, you're kidding yourself. They are cheaters in the first degree. But why? They haven't needed to cheat. With the exception of just being a fan, I will say that the one time where I do believe cheating really helped them was when they beat the St. Louis Rams for their first Super Bowl championship. I believe if they didn't do that, if they didn't record those practice sessions, if they didn't find some sort of little nuance to where they knew it was going to happen, then I believe they might not have won that game. It was so close that you could make the argument, and I am, that that was the difference in the game. Obviously, Tom Brady had to still make that drive to end the game. They had to kick the field goal. Stuff still had to go their way. They didn't win the game simply and only because of cheating, but they still gained an advantage by doing that right there. Since then, everything they've been accused of has gained them nothing other than putting a tarnish on their legacy. It doesn't make any sense. Even if you focus on this one instance alone, the instance of deflating the balls gained them nothing. Now all of a sudden you've had Belichick come out, say he had absolutely no idea that any such thing was going on. He didn't even know the rule about the pressurization of the footballs. Okay, maybe you can believe that. Tom Brady comes out, says the same thing. I find that extremely hard to believe. Because basically what they're saying is they're putting it on some random equipment manager or assistant equipment manager or somebody who has access to the footballs that they made some random decision without anybody's knowledge to just alter the footballs only on the New England side. It has not been altered on the Indianapolis side. But it begs the question of why. If New England was that confident, and they should have been because Indianapolis had no running game, the defense has been a good season for them, but they didn't have a great season. They're not known as one of the best defenses in the league. They put a lot of pressure on the quarterback, but other than that, they're not necessarily one of the best defenses in the NFL. So New England had every reason to go into that game and say that they were going to win, and they did just that. So why tamper with the footballs? Why do any of the things that they have done along the way to get around the rules, to bend the rules, to break the rules? They are too good for that. It doesn't make any sense. Perhaps some of you can explain it to me. Why would somebody be willing to put their reputation on the line if anything ever came out that anybody in a high-ranking position had knowledge of these things? Why would you be willing to tarnish your reputation for something as minuscule as gaining the slightest bit of advantage? Because the New England Patriots, with the exception of the games that they've actually lost, the games that they've won, for the most part, they've been so far and away the better team that it just doesn't make any sense for them to have even bothered in the first place. Do things the right way, because I don't care if you want to say it didn't alter the game. I'm freely admitting it did not alter the game. New England wins whether the footballs are at 12 and a half, 14 and a half, 11 and a half pounds, whatever you want to say that they are at. New England probably wins that game. It didn't change the outcome. So why put yourself in a position to where your integrity can be questioned? It doesn't make any sense. It will not make any sense. And quite frankly, it does nothing but take away from the legacy of the New England Patriots, who by far and away are one of the best teams of all time. Whether you hate them as I do, whether you love them as plenty of people that I know do, it just doesn't make any sense. Perhaps some of you can explain to me why anybody would be willing to put themselves on the line. Obviously, I know everybody wants to win championships. Everybody wants to give themselves that little leg up. Otherwise, you wouldn't have had the whole steroid era in baseball, which is a whole different topic in and of itself. But it just doesn't make any sense to put yourself in a situation where something that really isn't even going to give you that much of an advantage is tampered with. That'll do it for today. I hope to see you soon. We're going to be talking more about some topics later on. Have a good one. So much space.